Hello everyone, welcome back to Rolling Solo. My name is Adam Smith, and today we're playing Gloom of Kilforth. This is part 5 of the playthrough, and I hope you're enjoying so far. I want to thank everybody for your feedback, comments so far. It's been awesome. The journey has been fun so far. Vognus hasn't had too much fun yet. He's been getting a little bit pounded here and there, but he's been doing okay and has actually regained 4 AP for the upcoming term, which is a nice change of events for him. There are a couple things I want to go over before we begin this particular playthrough video to ensure that we're playing 100% correct without any major mistakes made. The first thing I want to make mention of is that we had finished the night phase at the end of the last video. So the one thing that you're supposed to do when you do the night phase is you pull your night card. I did that. This caused a Badlands location, actually the first Badlands location we have ever had, to go into Gloom. And because of that, we have to pull a plot card based on the ancient ability, as you can see right here. It says for our particular ancient we're using that if a Badlands location goes into Gloom, we pull a plot card. I'll explain to you what plot cards mean and what happens with these, because they're nasty. Okay, we got the Roaches of Penance, and it's a quest. We can destroy it. Those are the two keywords, and it says here, Fester Roaches, vile insects that feast on the blood of warriors and drain the wounds of those injured in battle, are spawning throughout the land. Teeming mounds of the grotesque creatures appear wherever there is conflict. The good people of the land must unite to defeat this revolting new threat. To defeat, all heroes must lose 1 HP. This Badlands symbol right here just basically reconfirms for us that it is in fact going to be pulled where the night card landed. So it will be happening at the Dead Swamp, which kind of makes sense that there'd be some nasty creatures there. And it'd be very grotesque. If we defeat this by losing an HP, we gain a loot. And as well, if we do not do anything about this plot card, at the end when we finally are going up against our Ancient right here, the scary looking individual she is, she would actually gain this ability here on top of what she already has, which we do not want for having us lose 1 HP. So this is something to keep in mind. It's going to be here, something we need to go and try to clear. That's going to be something that's going to be really, really important. So that's the first thing. Second thing is, guys, is that in the last video, we cleared out a watchman. When we did so, I completely forgot to go ahead and grab either a coin, which I guess in this case would have just been one, or a loot token. I'm telling you right now, we need all the help we can get. I got to stop giving Vognus a rough time by not giving him the benefit of the doubt in these situations. I'm going to dig myself into this loot bag. We're going to pull a token for him and see what we get. We got the spyglass. Interesting. Okay, so we gained one discover AP. Oh, that's very cool. So that's going to allow us to spend that without spending an AP from our 4 here in order to discover at a location. And that's really cool. So in other words, we could say, for instance, try to discover the Dwarven Axe at the Lonely Gorge for free. That's awesome. By using the spyglass, we're able to see it from a distance, making less work for Vognus. So that's good. So that's the next thing. The other thing I want to note is that the poison card I had gotten rid of. I really apologize for this one because I went back on it in the last video. But remember when we lost this card because of the serpent here that said sacrifice one item? Well, guess what? You can only sacrifice cards that are in your asset area, so in-play cards. And this was not in play. It was considered a rumor in my hand and therefore it can only be discarded. So when it refers to discarding, that's talking about rumors coming out of your hand. That serpent ability talks specifically about sacrificing, so it does not actually take the poison out of my hand, as it can only be discarded from my hand, not sacrificed from my hand. So that's awesome. If I had have actually obtained the ingredients in the wretched bog and was able to go ahead and discover this and put it as an asset in play, then that serpent could have taken it from me. But because we luckily had it as a rumor, he could not. So we get that back. So things are going good for Vognus. See, maybe it's my fault that we're, you know, he's having such a tough time. The other thing I want to mention too, on top of everything else, is the night cards up here. We actually, noted by Scott, a subscriber on the channel, I really want to thank him a lot for going back and double checking this for me because it's quite a bit of work. But going back, he realized we actually at a certain point between, I believe, video 2 and 3, accidentally pulled, I think it happened in video Yeah, between 2 and 3. And I think it was where I pulled an extra knight card more than we currently deserved. So we're one knight card further into the game than we should be, meaning Vognus has had that much more places go into Doom, and, you know, so we're one ahead. So what we're going to do in order to kind of balance that out is we're going to skip the next knight card pull at the end of this current day that's coming up. So that'll be something we have to remember. And then, of course, our dice here talking about how many knight cards are in play won't go up either and all that good stuff. But that's it. So just a couple things to note. Of course, every single one of them guys made the game harder for Vognus. As you can tell, if I was cheating, I certainly didn't make it any better on myself. So that's kind of funny. So we're going to go ahead now. We got the great thing about this turn going into this particular day is Vognus is more than prepared. He has 4 AP. Now, the nasty side of this, guys, is that he starts his turn in the Rolling Hills. And when you do so, you have to engage the enemies there. So the nasty thing is we have to fight this troll, and we never even had a chance to go and become hidden because you lose your hidden tokens overnight. So we're going to have to fight this guy. We do have the chance to escape him if we choose to do so. But we're going to have to battle him, and we may just want to go after him and see if we can take him on. Regardless, we obviously don't have surprise because we're not hidden, so we're not going to get that benefit. We're also not hidden, so we can't evade. So we have to move right into battle. So I'm going to grab the dice tray here. We're going to do our best with our character to try to take this guy down. He has 4 health, which is a little high, but I mean, we have 4 health too. So it's going to be a relatively even fight because he's rolling 3 dice. That troll's coming at us in the rolling. He's basically found us in the Rolling Hills. So story-wise, Vognus has woken up in the Rolling Hills thinking he was refreshed, safe, and everything else. And then in busts this gigantic troll looking to take him down. Vognus is going to grab 3 dice for himself, and I'm going to get 3 black dice for Vognus and 3 red dice for the troll. Oh, here we go. This is going to be quite the battle because I don't know how this is gonna work out, but I sure as heck hope it doesn't take Vognus out here. Here we go. Let's see what happens. Okay, so we ended up getting a 1-on-1 hit. So essentially, we got 1 hit off the troll. So we'll take that away, and Vognus lost 1 AP in the health as well. Now, just to note, guys, because we were in a location with the monster already, we have to be engaged with him. We didn't have to spend an AP to, 8 AP to become engaged with him, if that makes sense. We weren't starting the fight ourselves. We woke up in a location with a monster, so we are forced to engage, regardless of spending AP. So now what we have to do is decide whether we escape. Now, if I chose to escape right now, it'd be kind of stupid because I could move to a different location, but I'd lose all my AP and I'd be done for the day. Now, I don't really want to do that. I want to see how much further I can go. Maybe if we get into a dire situation with rolling, we'll see how it goes. I'm going to go another round here with the troll. And of course, we have fate tokens. Don't forget about that. We can use those as well as discarding rumors if we want to gain an extra fate in our battle. So let's see. Oh my goodness. Oh wow. That didn't go to plan. Holy. Okay, guys. Well, if you want to learn about what happens when you get defeated, this is going to teach you a little bit about that. I rolled an insanely high roll. And the really nasty thing is we're going to do this in order. So the very first thing you do is you check to see if the foe is defeated. And with 3 hits that I managed to do with my dice here, he is certainly defeated. So the crazy thing about this is he is defeated. When he's defeated, I can go ahead and gain rewards. So we do this step first. So we're going to go ahead, and what am I going to do here? I can either take 3 coins and keep or go for a loot token. I'm going to take 3 coins because I want all the money I can get. Although I'm not too sure what I'm going to lose when I go under, because now I've actually lost the battle. And if I have, let's see here, I'm going to end up, ooh, that's nasty. Okay, lots of bad things happen to me. It says that my hero, when he dies, is going to lose a lot of his gold. That's really bad. Oh, that's terrible. Okay, this is really bad, guys. So what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to choose to take a loot token because I know based on the rules that if I take gold, I'm losing it because my hero just died. And I know that because I've kind of looked at the rules in advance. And what else would I get is 3 gold. My goodness, he just cannot catch a break. So he gets 3 gold regardless, whatever I chose. And then, of course, I'm going to take the troll and I'm going to add him to my to my pile of rumors, I guess, essentially. So that resolves that. The other thing I can do is, let's see, take an encounter. I'm okay with taking him into my hand. I'm going to do that because I can probably use one of his keywords versus going for the item, just so you guys are aware. I had a choice there and I preferred that. Now, the next thing you do after you do the foe defeated check is you do the hero defeated check. If the hero has no HP, well, from those three hits I just suffered, I just lost everything that Vognus had. So all those go away, sadly. So Vognus has been defeated, sadly. That's not all that happens. It says here we make camp and end their hero turn immediately, even if part of a team and blah, 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 which we are not. We don't have to worry about that. We sadly, this is the step that I was talking about here with the gold. You have to return their gold to the token pool, meaning all six of the gold, which would have been perfect for getting the five we need to get to that end of the chapter, has been completely wiped out because of that troll. Oh my gosh. That's nasty. Okay, so then the next thing that happens is I can either sacrifice one asset or discard one rumor. So I can go into my hand here and take a look and maybe just see what's the best thing to get rid of. I've got an enemy humanoid mountain. I don't have any other mountain cards. I'll probably need a mountain at some point. Maybe now is when I actually just say to get rid of that that poison, because I don't plan on going back to that wretched bog. So I think that's the one to go. So I'm going to take the poison. Oh, it's just a useful card though. But I'm heading the other way. My goal is to head down to the tribal chiefess. So I'm going to have to let it go, guys. This card has been in my hand so many times, but it is gone now. So I'm discarding that. And then I return the standee, or I guess in my case, the miniature, back to Sprawl City, which is terrible because it's a gloom location right now. There's a civil war going on in there. And I've been returned back there. And then it says that I cannot be affected by abilities and stuff like that. So that's essentially it. And my day is done. Now, the only positive in this whole situation is, as I said at the beginning of the video, I'm not going to go ahead and be pulling any type of knight card because we are one knight card too far ahead. So this is going to stay at 7 because we have 7 knight cards in play. I will pull no card. This will tick down to 1, so the Veil of Fog only has one more turn that we can only move one a day. But you know what, guys, at the end of the day, if anything, this actually might have been kind of a help for us in terms of movement, because the Veil stopped us from moving quickly anyway, and now we're at a central location and can potentially move in different areas of the map. So even though we got knocked off here, there could be a positive twist to this, I hope. So there we go. And we can start a new day, essentially. So what we can do at this point is, obviously, Vognus comes back at full health because he died. So that's the only other positive, too, is you get everything. When you die completely, you come back ready to go for the next turn. So I'm just dropping all his AP and HP there. And we're ready to rock. So that didn't exactly go as planned, I can tell you that much. But here we go. We're starting the next day. Now, let's make some decisions here on what we want to do. We know for our saga quest, sorry about that. We know for our, for our chapter one quest, we still need this stranger keyword or a plains keyword. And we've got the stranger one right here. Now, the problem is we're just as far away as we were in the Rolling Hills, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. We're actually further away now. Problem being, too, the Veil of Fog only allows us to move one space at a time per turn. So even if I wanted to burn all of my actions to run through here, I couldn't do that. So that's pretty nasty. What do I do here? I could also head to the open heath and hope that I find what I need there, too. That may not be a bad idea because at least it's not in gloom. And I'd also be heading up to where the plot is, and I could potentially go to discard that. Let's do that. I like that idea. Let's head to the Lost Forest. We haven't actually gone to the forest yet, so why don't we go on an adventure? So the first thing I'm going to do is you lose an AP in order to get hidden, because I don't know what surprises are lurking around the corner here. I'm going to use another AP to move Vognus. He's going to charge from the... He's leaving the Civil War, which is just erupting inside of Sprawl City, heading into the Lost Forest for his first journey ever, deep, deep into the forest of Kilforth. Now, we moved into a forest location, so we're going to pull an encounter card to find out what we run into, and we found what appears to be a lost village. Okay, so maybe there's something good here. This is considered a place, an abode, and a forest. It's a map trophy. We can perform a free market action here. Hey, there we go, something positive. Now, of course, we still need to encounter this in order to allow for this. So let's see, we need to, I guess this is a place. This is something I'm actually not too familiar with. I might have to do a quick check just to be sure that I play this one correctly. But with places, if I'm not mistaken, they're a little bit different in how you encounter them. And I just want to make 100% sure that I do this correctly. Let's see here, defeat check, engagement. This is considered a... So essentially, because this is a place, you don't automatically engage it, first off. If it's an enemy, you automatically are engaging it to fight it. But what I can do right now, based on my actions, is I can confront it, because it's considered a place, and there's no obstacles present, so I don't have to worry about that. So in terms of confronting, I'm just going to take a quick look and see. For places, it says, perform a test against any one of the place's attributes which has a value, hero's choice, and attempt to defeat this encounter. This hero has already performed a test. So the cool thing is I'm here, I have 2 AP, I can roll continuously to try to get above one of these numbers. I'm obviously, with this being an influence of 3, going to try to influence my way into the Lost Village. So I'm going to try to talk my way and hope that they allow me entry into this. That makes the most sense for me because I have 2 and 2, which gives me 4 when I'm rolling going into this. So I think that makes the most sense. I'm going to go ahead and use 1 AP, and we're going to go ahead and confront this place to attempt to... I guess, get inside of this location. So, here we go. I don't know what's going to happen, guys, but we're going to give this a shot. So, here's my first attempt at persuading them with my willpower, or willing my way through it, I guess. Okay, so 1 success. So, partway there, not bad. And then what I can do here is I can... I could spend the last AP. I guess I'm pretty safe, so I probably should do this. And I can't move any further anywhere, and I have no need to heal. So I'm going to go ahead and do this. We're going to roll 1 more time with 4 dice. So we've already got 1 success, so I'll mark that with a gold. We're rolling again, and of course I have fate that I can use, so I just need to get through. I need 2 more successes. And I got 1. Okay, so I got 1, and I can go ahead now and use a fate token if I wanted to, just to make sure that we pass it. I think I'm going to do that, actually. I think that would make the most sense. So I'm going to try to... get past the Lost Village. And it's a free market action too. So maybe by taking gold, it would be a good idea. And then we can potentially buy something. That would be kind of fun. I'm gonna go ahead and use a fate token in order to get that extra success. So now we've actually defeated the encounter of the place. So now it goes into my hand. And because I've defeated it, I gain the rewards now. So I can either take the gold loot, or I can go into the bag. I'm probably just going to take, you know, be safe here and take the 2. Now, this was a counter, so I'm going to use this as one of the 2 that I can take. So here's 2 gold is what I'm taking. The reason I'm doing this too is not only I can go to the market and buy something, but I do need 5 gold still to complete the chapter. So this now, I can choose whether to take a title or I can keep this in my hand. And you know what? Let's grab a title. Let's try to get something a little different here. Let's draw a reward card. So I'm going to end up, let me see, do I really want to do that? Oh, so tough. I'm going to discard it. I'm going to go for the, title. I want to see what we can potentially get here. Horse rider. Hey, that's pretty cool. So title is steed. The deed is a veil, gain 1 move AP, so that'll allow us to move quicker. Man, we really need that because we've been just slogging our way through this. That's a great card to get. So Vognus is really happy to get a really cool looking horse. That's an amazing card. It says he was the finest destrier in the land. Oh, destrier, I'm going to get murdered on that one. A proven leader amongst the war horses. It's a title and it's found in the Lost Forest. For the love, please be close to me. Are you kidding me? Is that some kind of joke? That can't be possible. I literally found the car. What? How is that even possible? Okay, so I found the title, or I found this card, and it can be discovered here, guys. I'm in the Lost Forest. That's an incredible pull. I don't even know what the odds are of that. Maybe that's common. I don't know. I have no idea, but that's insane. Maybe Vognus' luck is turning around a little bit here. So I gained this as a reward card, so it's going to go in my hand, and of course, I have to discover it. I don't have any more AP to do that on this turn, guys, so I can't discover it this turn, but at the start of next turn, I'm going to have a horse that I found in the Lost Forest. Maybe dying wasn't such a bad thing after all. Now, the other thing to make mention of is I'm just double checking here because it says here map trophy, perform a free market action. And I'm just wondering, let me double check on the keyword here for trophy because I believe as soon as I defeated it, that means that I can go ahead and just do a market action if I so choose. And I'll show you guys what the market action is. It's kind of cool, actually, if I do decide to actually do that. And sorry, that was a trophy keyword. So I just want to make 100% sure that I read that keyword correctly and I use that at the correct time. So trophy says, same as trophy above, but the benefit effect must be performed if possible. It is not optional. It said on the card that it was a map trophy. So it says map ability stays in force while the card is in play. If it refers to an interaction that can be made with this card, such as a battle or a test, then the ability only affects these interactions within itself. Otherwise, it's a mandatory effect that affects all game elements. Trophy. Forced. Ooh, that's a tough one to tell what that actually... that means. I don't know if I defeated the encounter, so my assumption is that I can go ahead and do a market action. So how about this? We're at the end of the day. This is the one thing I'm going to double check on to see whether or not, because I already discarded the card, I beat the encounter and I chose to take a title, which I can do down here. But I want to double check, maybe you guys can let me know. I'm also going to look this up myself, but maybe that we can actually take a look and determine whether or not, I'm allowed to do a free market action right now, or if that had to still be in play or something like that, and for me to do it. Maybe I wasn't supposed to try to take out the Lost Village. It had to be still in play for me to do it. So I don't think that I get this map, but it also says it's a trophy, and I did go ahead and defeat the encounter, so maybe I do. But anyway, we'll put that aside for now. That's something that I'm gonna come back in the next video and we'll talk about. The really, really cool thing is that I guess we're at the end of our day, so we can actually move forward with a regular night phase, and we know what that means. The Veil of Fog, actually, it says right here, when night begins on the third day after this card is played, discard it. And so we've now taken that card down. We no longer have the Veil of Fog sitting in Kilforth, thank goodness. So the weather is back to normal. We're going to go ahead and draw our night card and hope it's not a Badlands one, because this could be nasty. Of course it is. Okay, it's an Orc Assassin. It's an event. Discard a stranger from play. Oh, no. Okay, well, a stranger from play, I guess the question would be is when it says from play, is that from my assets or is that from play? I'm thinking it's from actually out in the world. I do have two strangers, so I'm going to go ahead and discard probably the Rosen Crusader, I think. He's a little bit easier and he's actually closer to me. I'm going to start the Tribal Chieftess. She's further away from me and I'm less likely to go over there. Plus it's in Gloom, so it's going to go away. So I'm discarding the Tribal Chieftess, and then of course the Endless Brackens goes into Gloom, which is right here in front of me. All right, so we're going to flip that over, and that wonderful location is now no longer pleasant, and of course the Orc Assassin is sitting there waiting for us. We're going to go ahead and tick up our night count in terms of how many night cards are in play there to 8. And we're good. All right. I'll see you guys in the next video. Hope you guys are enjoying. Give me a thumbs up and...